This is the Sabercat Report with Saguaro Sabercat football coach Jason Mohns on the Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060 KD, US, Arizona. And now, here's Coach Mohns.
Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Show here on AM 1060 KD, US, Arizona. Vince Delicio here. It is time for the Sabercat Report, where we feature the Saguaro Sabercats head football coach Jason Mohns and his weekly post-game wrap. And also joined by my broadcast partner from last night's game, Mr. Ryan Sikora. Coach Mohns, how are you, sir?
Good morning, guys. How are you?
All right. Walking a little lighter today and watching some film, working out with your team. I'm sure quite a game last night. I got to tell you that it was exciting. It was low scoring, obviously, initially, and then something clicked in the third quarter. Did you deliver a pretty impassioned Arab Parsegian speech at halftime? What happened?
Yeah, you know, I think we just talked about just settling in and doing what we do, and it was tough. You know, I thought we started the game really well offensively. We were moving the ball up and down the field, and then, you know, got a field goal on our first drive and then kind of stalled on our second one. And I think we had a couple injuries that just kind of took the wind out of our sail, and a lot of the stuff that we had kind of scripted based on personnel kind of got thrown up in the air. And so we just had to settle back in. We had to just kind of go back and get back to the basics and the stuff that we've kind of hung our hat on up to this point in the season. And we felt like if we did that, we'd have a good chance. And then, you know, obviously credit to our defense. Our defense played phenomenal last night, took the ball away, gave us some short fields, and we capitalized and scored enough points on a good team and played great defense and obviously came away with a big-time win.
Yeah, and, Coach, you mentioned that defense one guy that really impressed me was John Butler, but he didn't really make the big plays. But one guy who really made the big plays, for me at least, was Myler Teramo. And he's such a fascinating individual and how energetic he is. And what kind of player is he, and how does his energy really help the team?
Yeah, his name's Miller, but he goes by Bo. So, you know, Bo is he's our Florida transplant and showed up this spring. And just has a dynamic personality, great energy, loves the game, plays with a ton of passion, and just one of those guys. When he's on the field, he makes everybody around him better because he just plays with great intensity and great passion. He had a great game last night. His mom was in town from Florida, first time that she had been here to be able to see him play, and so he was playing with a little bit extra motivation last night. He really was a spark for us on defense, and the interception at the end kind of put that thing away.
Yeah, amazing play all the way around. But let's talk about the defense last night. And Tristan Monday came in, played big once again. I mean, this guy is incredible. He was all over the field, as well as some other stalwarts there that really stepped up and played well. Talk a little about the defensive game plan coming in and how that all that played out for you.
Yeah, you know, I thought Jim Camarillo, our D coordinator, and that our defensive staff is second to none. I mean, if you go across the guys that we have on that side of the ball, they're coaching. I mean, we've got a phenomenal coach at every position, and multiple guys that have D coordinator experience. I think we have three guys that have been D coordinators on our staff at the highest level in Arizona. You know, I thought we did a great job with the game plan. Our kids were dialed in. You know, obviously the probably the biggest offensive line. I don't know if there's in many high school teams in the country that have a bigger, more talented offensive line than Sierra Canyon. They had both their tackles are Power Five guys. Their guard committed to Air Force, and two other guys that were big and good too. So we knew we had our work cut out. You know, Tristan going against tackle, one committed to Oregon, one committed to Stanford. He was the best player in the field, you know, last night, and he dominated those guys and was a huge impact for us. But Mike Alutu, who plays some two ways for us, who's our starting right tackle, played a bunch on the D line last night, had his best game. He really played physical. Magnum West was really good up front. Zach McAroli, who's a converted linebacker, who's the smallest guy up there, but plays with the biggest heart. He was not getting blown back. He was taking on double teams. I mean, he was scratching a claw. He's beat to crap this morning, but he gave us everything he had. I thought those guys did a great job. And then, you know, obviously our secondary, you know, Bo and Cole Shivers and those guys, Thomas DeCesaro, they locked it down and they were opportunistic, forced turnovers. And, you know, that's what you need to do to beat a good team. You got to protect the ball and you got to try to take it away.
Turning that focus to the offense, I guess my last question is probably going to be, what went into the decision to obviously Ridge has been great the first five games, and last night was game six, and you bring in all these transfers, and Devin's a great quarterback, and he's a good athlete, and he brings a different dimension. But what was the decision to go ahead and split time between the two?
Yeah, I mean, I just think you know, we've got two great players. I mean, it's kind of the same thing we look at with the running back. You know, Zacchaeus Cooper gets eligible, and the other two, Brian and Jaden, have been playing so well. Well, what do you do? You want to give, you know, you want to give Zacchaeus some run as well. So we kind of look at the quarterback position the same way, to be honest with you. If you got two really good ones, you got to find a way to get them on the field and utilize their strengths and force the defense to have to prepare for it. So, you know, Devin's a phenomenal player. He brings a different element to the game. And you know, that was tough. That was a tough first game for all those transfers to go right into a game of that caliber, that kind of intensity against that caliber of an opponent. So, Devin brings an element to the team that's dynamic and can do some different things in the read option game. Obviously, he has a big time arm, makes throws. So, you know, there was not much of a decision. That was the plan all along. And Ridge has been phenomenal, like you said. Ridge, you know, he's just gotten better each week. He's got a really good grasp and control of the offense right now, and he kind of got in last night. And when we had the injuries and we tried to give a different look and we were kind of stalled out a little bit, I thought he came back in and settled us down and took control and kind of got us back on track. So, I think you know, we're going to utilize our players, we're going to utilize our talent, and try to be able to attack defenses in a lot of different ways. So that's always our plan.
Coach, congratulations once again on the win last night. Big win over Sierra Canyon out of Chatsworth, California. You got another big one this week, probably the biggest game of the year. You're hosting Horizon for homecoming. Horizon's coming in with a 6-0 record, so this is going to be a battle, and you got your work cut out for you. Obviously, we saw Horizon play last week. They're pretty good, but you guys are pretty good too. So congrats, and Coach, good luck.
All right, guys. Appreciate you.
All right. So, Ryan, player of the game last night.
I mean, you can go down the line, bunch of great performers. That first half, Derek English, that first drive really dominated the headlines. For me, it's got to go on the defensive side of the ball. And Tristan Monday was great up front. And
yeah,
the guys who are going to get the turnovers on the secondary are going to get all the headlines, but Tristan Monday causes those turnovers with his pressure. I'm going to give it to Tristan Monday.
I agree. I agree with you wholeheartedly. And I was a little torn because Javen had a great game as well. Derek English played extremely well early. So great game all the way around. Ryan, thanks again for calling in. We'll see you next week.
Thank you, Vince.
All right.